Welcome everyone. Today we are going to cover the topic simplex method. Here in today's lecture we'll be solving two examples of maximization type. So before that, let's see what type of example is, what is the pattern of example, and then how to write its standard form. So example is solve using simplex method the following linear programming problem, which is called as LPP. So maximize z equal to 5x1 plus 3x2. Such this equation is called as objective function, and this objective function is to be maximized or minimized. In short, we can say it is to be optimized subject to the constant. So these are the conditions called as constants: x1 plus x2 less than equal to 2, 5x1 plus 2x2 less than equal to 10, 3x1 plus 8x2 less than equal to 12, where x1 and x2 are always non-negative, that is 0 on positive. So these three conditions are called as constants, and z is called as objective function. Now in maximization problem, we have to ensure that all constants are of less than or equal to type, which are here already. Okay, if not, we have to make it by multiplying it by minus sign. Okay, so here all are already in less than or equal to type, so in standard form we have to make them equalities. I repeat, we have to write these constants in equality form. So obviously left side of these constants are less than or equal to right side. It means if we add something to left side, then they may get equal to right side. So what to add? These addition are denoted by s1, s2 and s3. These are the three variables known as slack variables. If we are adding the variables, those variables are called slack variables. If we are subtracting the variables, they are called surplus variables. So let's see how to write standard form for simplex method. Maximization z equal to 5x1 plus 3x2 as it is. Now there are three inequality constraints, therefore three variables to be added or used. That's why we also add them in every equation with zero coefficient if not required. So 0s1, 0s2 and 0s3. So you can see all five variables are available in objective function. Subject to first constraint, which was x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 2. Now it will be x1 plus x2. Now something to add. So let's assign s1 to first constraint, s2 to second constraint and s3 to third constraint. And other variables are available with zero coefficient. Now they are equal to RHS. Therefore, x1 plus x2 plus 1s1, 0s2, 0s3 equal to 2. 5x1 plus 2x2 plus 0s1 plus s2 plus 0s3 equal to 10. And 3x1 plus 8x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 1s3 equal to 10. Now, we have added s1 to first constraint, s2 to second constraint and s3 to third constraint. And now this inequality becomes equations. This is called standard form. So you can see every equation contains all five variables x1, x2, s1, s2, s3, where s1, s2, s3 are known as slack variables. Now we put this standard form into tabular form for solution. Now listen carefully. For every variable, for every constant, there is a formula how to write. So first we write the basic table, where first column is basic variables which we have just added s1, s2, s3. Those will come under basic variable column. Then we have CB. CB means coefficients of those variables. So we know in objective function, coefficient of s1, s2, s3 are 0, 0, 0. So they are always 0 in first table. This is called first iteration. Third column is of XB. XB is nothing but the RHS of the constraint, that is 2, 10 and 12. So they are listed here. Then we have all variables, all five variables here: x1, x2, s1, s2, s3. Then from constraints, all the coefficients are taken as three rows. So 1, 1, 1, 0, 0 is your first row. Then second constraint is second row. Third constraint coefficient is third row. Whereas on the top of these variables, their coefficient from the objective functions are written, that is 5, 3, 0, 0, 0. 53000. And at last, we have the column minimum positive ratio. Its calculation is later. So I repeat, this is minimum positive ratio to be chosen. Now, once this basic table is filled, we have first calculation as delta j. And this delta j row is called as bottom row of iteration. Now, listen carefully. Here, we find first z value, which is 0. Now, how it comes? Formula for z is nothing but summation of cb into xb. I repeat, formula for z is a summation of the product cb and xb. So, it is 0 into 2 plus 0 into 10 plus 0 into 12, which comes to 0. So, in first iteration, in every example, z comes to 0. In first iteration, in every example, cb column will be 0 because we are solving for s1, s2 and their coefficients are always 0 in the objective function. Minus 5, minus 3, 0, 0, 0. You can see they are the negation of these top elements. These are the coefficients of all variables from objective function. So, how to get it? Delta, this row is called as delta j row. So, first delta 1 value is obtained using cb into x1 plus 0 into 5 plus 0 into 3 minus top element. I repeat, this minus 5 is obtained using this calculation. 0 into 1 plus 0 into 5 plus 0 into 3, total comes to 0, minus 5 is minus 5. Similarly, for minus 3, column is different, whereas this 0, 0, 0 column is fixed. So, 0 into 1 plus 0 into 2 plus 0 into 8, which is 0, minus 3 is minus 3. Similarly, this comes to 0, 0 and 0. So, in first iteration, this row is always negation of the top element and it is called as delta j row. Now, if this delta j elements are 0 or positive, I repeat, if all these elements in delta j row are 0 or positive, then we stop the calculation. And if we get at least one negative number, then we have to proceed for second iteration. Now, here we find smallest negative number in this row, which is minus 5. So, corresponding to minus 5, there is variable x1. So, now x1 will be entering into calculation. I repeat, currently calculation was done for these three variables s1, s2, s3. Now, x1 is entering. So, definitely when x1 is entering, it will replace some variable out of s1, s2, s3. For that, we have another calculation, which variable to replace. So, when x1 is entering, corresponding column is called key column. So, 1, 5, 3, this first column is called as key column because minus 5 is the smallest negative number in delta j. So, we highlight this column. Okay. Now, we come to last column, minimum positive ratio. Minimum positive ratio is taken with xb value and this key column elements, that is 2 upon 1, 10 by 5 and 12 by 3, so which is 2, 2 and 4. The heading of this column is minimum positive ratio. So, minimum positive value we have to choose here. If it is negative, if it is 0 or sometimes infinity, we have to neglect those values. Okay, so only positive value to be obtained here. So, here there is a tie. Because in first row and second row, there is a common value, that is 2, 2. Now, it's up to you which row to select. I have selected here first row. So, since first row is selected, corresponding row is our key row and I have highlighted by bounding it. So, this is corresponding key row and this is corresponding key column and corresponding variable is S1, which is outgoing variable. So, this S1 is now replaced by X1. So, as already said, X1 is incoming element or variable and S1 is now outgoing element. So, instead of S1, now X1 will take the place. Okay. Now, S1 is going, X1 is entering and corresponding row including XB value is called key row. And The point common to key column and key row is called key element. So here 1 is the key element. So we got which variable is going, which variable is incoming. So we write s1 as x1 here, rest of the variables as it is s2 and s3. Now we know this cb column is the coefficient of this variable, so s2 and s3 remain 0 0, whereas x1 coefficient is 5 in the objective function, so it is here. Now while writing these rows, I repeat, starting from xb, while writing these rows we have to operate separately. Now the rule is, we have to ensure that key element is 1, which is already here for this example. So key element is 1, that's why we write that row as it is. So 2 1 1 1 0 0 is taken as it is. This is called row 1, row 2 and row 3. Okay, whereas now our intention is, we have to make the elements in that column 0. I repeat, consider this as a matrix, and operation, row operation will be used. Using this key element, we have to make 5 and 3 0. So operation will be, for this second row will be R2 minus 5 R1, because R2 element is 5 and R1 element is 1. That's why 5 minus 5 times R1 gives us 0 here. So 5 minus 5 times R1 is a 0. 10 minus 5 times 2, that is 10, gives us 0. 2 minus 5 is minus 3. 0 minus 5 is minus 5. 1 minus 5 times 0 is 1. And 0 minus 5 times 0 is 0. In this way, the element in key column is made 0 and other elements are changed accordingly. Similarly, for third row, which is 3 here, we have to make it 0. So operation will be R3 minus 3 R1. So 3 minus 3 times 0 here. 12 minus 3 times 2, that is 6, is a 6 here. 8 minus 3 times 1 is 5. 0 minus 3 is minus 3. 0 minus 0 is 0. 1 minus 3 times 0 is 1 here. So again our table is filled. Again we go for delta j row. For delta j row, we have first z value and then this entire row. Again z value can be obtained using xb into cb's summation. So it's a product sum. 5 into 2, 10, plus 0 into 0, plus 0 into 6, so z value is 10. Similarly for 0, we have calculation, 5 into 1, plus 0 into 0, plus 0 into 0, so total is 5, 5 minus top element is 5, 0. Similarly for this column, we have 5 into 1, minus 0, plus 0, so it is 5, minus top element 3, so it comes to. For this element, we have 5 into 1, which is 5, rest are 0, so 5 minus top element is 0, that's why 5. Similarly, this 0 and 0 can be obtained. Now, since all delta j values are positive, we are at optimal solution, because there is no negative value where it was the condition smallest negative number to be chosen. There is no negative value, that's why we are at optimal solution, and all delta j's are positive, that's why z max is this z value is our final answer. Only x1 is entered here, whereas x2 is not entered. So x1 value is here, not 5 but 2. So x1 is a 2, x2 is a 0 is the optimal solution for given example.